intelligence agencies and those connected to them do sometimes fund, protect, and collude with terrorists to advance other agendas. Often men motivated by money and not political or religious causes are maneuvered by puppet masters to leave behind a convenient trail of evidence. It certainly appears that this was the case on 9/11. Many people claim the US government would never even consider launching terrorist attacks on its own soil or against its own citizens and their interests. Yet official declassified documents have revealed that in 1962, US military chiefs had given their backing to a series of well-advanced plans to stage false flag terrorist operations on US interests to provoke a war with Cuba. Although Operation Northwoods was over four decades ago, it simply cannot be argued that the US military have developed more of a conscience over the years. During the Cold War, NATO, alongside intelligence agencies, armed and funded stay-behind armies to act as resistance in the event of a Soviet invasion. Inquiries carried out by the Belgian and Italian parliaments established that Operation Gladio was behind several atrocities across Western Europe in the 1970s and 80s. Gladio teams carried out terrorist operations as part of a strategy of tension. The resulting fear was used to manipulate public perception, while the blame was put on political dissidents. This important case demonstrates the desire by those in power to carry out terrorist attacks in order to further hidden agendas. Around 15 years ago, the BBC was all too aware of this.
Bisognava attaccare i civili, quello che è il popolo, le donne, i bambini, le persone innocenti, strane ad ogni gioco politico. Per una ragione semplice, perché bisognava obbligare questa gente, l'opinione pubblica italiana, a rivolgersi allo Stato, a rivolgersi al regime per chiedere maggiore sicurezza. Il ruolo della destra in Italia è stato proprio questo. Si è messo a servizio di apparati di Stato che hanno alimentato una strategia che giustamente è stata definita della tensione in quanto bisognava portare la gente ad accettare in qualsiasi momento, nell'arco di un trentennio dal 1960 al 1985-86, la possibilità di uno stato d'emergenza. Quindi la gente avrebbe barattato molto volentieri parte della sua libertà con la sicurezza di poter camminare sulle strade, viaggiare sui treni, salire sugli aerei, entrare in banca. Questa è la logica politica che sta dietro tutte le stragi, che rimangono impunite proprio perché lo Stato non può condannare se stesso o proclamare se stesso colpevole di quello che ha fatto.
The conspiracy files didn't include testimony on false flag terrorism from former intelligence officers like Alexander Litvinenko, formerly of the Russian FSB.
И когда произошли взрывы домов, я сразу понял, что это, вернее, не понял, правильно сказать, а у меня сразу возникли подозрения, что это дело рук моей бывшей организации. Они этот дом заминировали, и по чистой случайности жители дома обнаружили эту взрывчатку. Вот, завели уголовное дело с окраской терроризм. И начали искать террористов. И буквально через полтора дня они их нашли. Задержали этих людей, эти люди оказались офицерами ФСБ.
And myself, David Shaler, formerly of MI5.
Tunworth's intelligence was, we're told, shared with a small number of key officials.
They are still funding international terrorism.
Producer Guy Smith did acknowledge that false flag terrorism exists.
There's no doubt that the American government and other governments, no doubt the British government as well, has been involved in all sorts of operations in the past, false flag operations.
Since Smith appears to understand that the powers that be do use these tactics, why then didn't he present any of this context to the audience? A number of documents produced prior to 9/11 clearly show that the neocons had been lobbying for a US invasion of Afghanistan and Iraq in order to secure energy supplies for the US domestic market. They accepted that the American people would not support these plans absent some catastrophic and catalyzing event like a new Pearl Harbor.
I don't know.
Are people really worried the U.S. is going to go, a decent law-abiding country, and the U.S. is going to come in and say, we don't like the look of you, we're going to depose you? Isn't that something the U.S. has done quite often? How many countries has the U.S. attacked in the last 15 years?
Since World War II, there have been 72 interventions by the United States.
Oh, is that right?
Yes.
That's ludicrous.
Well, it's not ludicrous, it's true.
These are some of the countries where the United States, directly and indirectly, has overthrown governments, manipulated elections, and attacked popular movements since 1945. Bush's war on terror is just another brand name replacing the Red Menace as justification for a systematic aggression. This is well documented, yet it remains a kind of secret history, seldom reported in the West as a war of terror.
When the BBC touched on the war on terror, they failed to include any of the relevant information which showed how the arms, oil, and finance industries had benefited. Later on in the programme, they trivialised the lies which have led to hundreds of thousands of deaths in Iraq.
We know they have weapons of mass destruction. We know they have active programs. There isn't any debate about it.
Those weapons of mass destruction have got to be somewhere. Nope, no weapons over there. Maybe under here.
'9/11 was a key part of those lies, and whether an inside job or not, after it occurred, the US administration conspired to use it as justification for pre-planned wars.